Ow! Twittern! Ow! 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 Ow!
Sir? What's happened, sir? You've got your head stuck through some railings, sir.
I know that, Twittern.
But how on earth...
Excuse me, are you in difficulties?
Yes, but it's all perfectly under control. Thank
and...
you.
Oh! There. Ah!
You're free, sir. That was marvellous.
Oh, it's just a knack. Good day.
But who the blazes... This isn't funny, Twitten.
No, sir.
Ow. That really hurt.
The Return of Inspector Steam by Lynne Truss. Episode 1. Towards the End.
Brighton Police Station, June 16th, 1957. Dear Father, comma, I enclose with this a letter I wrote to you when I thought I was going to die. My apologies for its damp and blurry contents, but as will become clear when you read it, I was in an open boat at the time.
Big wave coming, sir!
Oh, no! Ah! Ah!
Evil Mrs. Vine had tricked us all into deadly peril. Even me.
Help!
But you'll be relieved to hear that we all got safely back on dry land, thanks to a rather miraculous occurrence. Father, does the word hovercraft mean anything to you? I wonder if that should be hyphenated. By an astonishing stroke of luck, a prototype hovercraft was being tested off the coast of Brighton that very afternoon we were adrift.
Oh, God! That's so loud!
You're telling me, dear!
You do realise that thing isn't actually touching the water?
Of course, once we were on dry land, we raced back to the station. But here's the funny thing. We found it exactly as we had left it. If the evil Mrs. Vine had been here, she had taken nothing. Even Mrs. Groynes' latest bag of stolen gold bullion was untouched. I didn't know what to think. Had things changed, or hadn't they? True, the following morning the inspector had mysteriously got his head caught in some railings on the seafront, but although that was quite unusual, at the same time it wasn't really beyond the realm of normal possibility. Anyway, I repeat, had things changed or hadn't they? Well, they had, yes. The answer is yes. Please, please don't ever tell Mother what I'm about to tell you. As I said, it did all start off seeming so normal, apart from the railings thing. It was a couple of days after we got back.
Look lively, Sergeant. Here come the Marines.
Oh, morning, sir.
Morning, Brunswick. Morning, Mrs. Groynes.
I was dying to talk to Mrs. Groynes in private, of course.
Morning, dear.
Good morning, Mrs. Groynes. Morning, Sergeant Brunswick.
Morning, son.
If the evil Mrs. Vine was bidding to take over all criminal activity in Brighton, what was she up to?
Oh, Inspector, did I already say morning to you, dear?
I believe you did, yes.
But for the time being, it was all bally good morning, good morning, good morning, with Mrs. G doing her bally clever impersonation of ladies who do.
Cups of tea, then, dears.
Oh, lovely.
As you know, Father, I'd long since given up trying to expose Mrs. Groynes as Brighton's brilliant criminal mastermind.
Oh, what a marvellous character Mrs. Groynes is.
Yes.
The others think she's a character.
It's so good to know there are some people in this world you can take completely at face value.
Then, all of a sudden, the door flew open. And standing in the bright sunlight was a handsome, uniformed stranger carrying two identical heavy metal boxes, like army ammunition canisters.
Pardon the intrusion.
Oh, that's better.
It was the mysterious stranger who had freed Inspector Steen from the railings.
Oh, hello.
The man I now know to be Captain Hoagland.
Get up, Brunswick.
Yes, sir.
And from the time Captain Hoagland came in, well, from then on, our whole world was turned upside down.
I'm looking for Inspector Steen.
Ah, that's me.
That's him.
Hoagland's the name, sir, from the Metropole. Damn his leg.
Oh, dear.
Captain Hoagland was dressed as a menial hotel porter, but there was something about him. Was it the limp, the officer-class accent, the telltale rusty pinholes on his coat, where a row of medals had often been suspended?
Would you like to sit down, Mr. Hoagland? Oh, I couldn't help noticing...
It's kind of you, Sergeant, but... this damn leg! But this won't take long, sir. I was asked by a patron of the hotel to deliver this box to a Mrs. Groynes.
Well, that's me, dear. Give it over if you like.
Of course. Quite heavy, I'm afraid, madam.
Oh, you're not wrong.
And then, quite coincidentally, someone at the door to the station asked me to bring this up, too. I expect they thought I worked here.
Oh.
Anyway, it's an urgent box for the famous Inspector Steen.
Oh, what's in it?
I'm afraid I don't know, sir.
Oh, good grief.
Will that be all? Damn this arm. Oh, will that be all, sir?
What? Oh, yes, definitely.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, sir, if I may say so. Yeah. My poor motherless niece and I enjoy your broadcasts on the Home Service very much.
Really? No, even children.
Law and the common man.
Law and the little man.
Of course, sir, the little man. When I think back, sir, to the war, to what we all...
Well, yes.
I sometimes feel it was for precisely such peacetime freedoms that we... I'll see myself out. Damn this hand!
God.
What an odd man. Not quite the ticket for the Metropole, surely.
He was very polite.
Yeah, look how he's cluttered up the place.
He looked a bit familiar to me. And the name, Hoagland.
Sir, I might be wrong about this.
Oh, listen to Clever Clogs here.
But I think he might be Captain Mad Hoagie Hoagland. The famous bomb disposal chap from the war, sir.
Oh, Mad Hoagie.
If you say so, Twitten.
You've gone all pink, dear.
It's just meeting him like that. He defused the Mansion House bomb, amongst others, sir.
Really?
And he did free your head from those railings this morning, sir.
That was him?
Yes, sir.
Well, that was just a knack. He said it himself. I'd have been out of there in no time if he hadn't come along.
Mad Hoagie Hoagland! Him! Oh, that's shocking.
It is,
yes. A man like that working at the Metropole delivering boxes? He defused the Southwark Bridge bomb, sir. The Mansion House, that big one at the Kennington Oval. You must remember, sir.
Not really, no.
Don't you really?
No.
He was a hero. A real hero.
A brave man.
A jolly brave man.
A very, very, very brave
Look,
man.
Are we going to open these boxes or not?
Oh, yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
I mean, what on earth is this? What do you mean,
I think I know, sir, but if it's what I think it is, it's come incredibly quickly.
So it's for you, then?
It's for the sergeant, sir.
What, me? What is it?
Oh, come on, then, Brunswick. Bring the box to my office and we'll find out. Find out what know-it-all Twitten's done now.
Yes, sir.
I just thought I should get the ball rolling, sir. I hope you don't mind.
Well, I haven't got a clue what's in mine.
Come on, Brunswick, do the handle.
Yes, sir.
Oh, what about a tip, sir? Shouldn't I run off?
Shut the door, Brunswick. Good. Sit down, Brunswick.
Yes, sir.
Do you know something, Sergeant? Much as I'm glad we all, every one of us, survived that ordeal at sea, there's something about Twitten that really...
I know, sir. You'd like to wring his neck.
Precisely. Or hit him. What I keep imagining is that we were all in that boat and Twitten fell in the water.
But he didn't fall in the water, sir.
I know. However, I keep imagining him bobbing in the water alongside the boat, you see, shouting for help and still telling me what to do and... Well, perhaps I shouldn't say what happens next.
Do you bang him with an oar, sir?
Yes! I shout, Twitten, for God's sake, shut up for once. Just shut up! And I bang him with... Now, what's all this? Oh, that boy!
What is it, sir?
It's your silver truncheon, Brunswick.
What silver truncheon?
Yes, yes, stay there. Now, it's possible I'm a bit confused, so just remind me when I first mentioned the possibility of the Silver Truncheon Award to you.
That would have been on Thursday, sir.
Thursday afternoon, in fact.
Yes, sir.
On the boat.
I was in a bit of a state, sir.
Yes.
I was saying I was going to leave the force, and you said, how about a Silver Truncheon to show how much we value all your bravery? Mm-hmm. And I said, thank you, sir. In that case, I'll stay.
Yes, that's what I thought. I'll kill that boy. I will, really.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.